I want to give this picture a pen like sketch feel. So I will begin this by creating a layer out of this, save it as to my desktop, portrait desktop save. Okay. Now I will go to Illustrator. Sorry, I will say I have image size 2500 pixels. That's what I care about now. So I will create a document in Illustrator about the same size. Let's make it RGB. Okay. And now I will create a black line. Select it, go to effects, zigzag, select the smooth, and I think this is about the amount I want. Okay, now I will select this line, go to object and expand it. And now I will move it here. I will do Command Alt Shift to duplicate it, and now I press Command D to repeat my motion. I can also select this, Command Alt Shift and Command D. Sorry, Command Alt Shift, Command D, Command D. Now I have some double lines which I will erase. This one here, this one here, and this one here. Now I won't need Illustrator any longer, so I will select this. Let's give it a stroke to select this and Command C to copy it. Now I go to Photoshop. Let's call this layer original image, original. Now, I am here in Photoshop. I will press Command V to paste as pixels my lines, and I will scale them until they cover the whole of my picture. Now, I will hide them for now. I will duplicate this layer by pressing Command J and desaturate it. Command U and desaturate it. I also press Command M to open curves and increase the contrast of my image a little bit by increasing my blacks and my whites. Okay, that's it. Now I will use this line here to fill the 5 tones of my image. So let's begin with the first tone. I will create a new layer and call it gray 1. Now, I will select here, go to select, color range, and I will try to select the lighter tone of my image. Let's say this is it. I don't want any whites on this, so I will create this mask. So now I have this mask and I go to my gray 1 and mask it. Let's create a new layer. Command backspace to fill it with white. And now I will take my lines and drop them in here. So I have my first tone created. Now let's create a second tone. I will create a new layer and call it gray 2. Now the second tone will be darker. I deselect all this and go to my original image, go to select color range and select a darker tone now. Right here, let's say right here, okay. Now I will go to my layer and create a layer mask. Again, open this And now I will take my lines, duplicate them, and drop them in my gray 2 layer. But because gray 2 is grayer, I need more shadow. So I will copy again my lines and press Command T, and while pressing Shift, I will rotate them 90 degrees. So this second tone is a bit darker. Now let's create another tone, gray 3. Now I will again hide these layers and go to select color range and select an even darker tone. Let's go here. Create a new mask on this. And now I will take the lines from gray 2, duplicate them and put them in this layer. And now I will also duplicate them, and while pressing Shift, I will rotate it 45 degrees. And now I am beginning to have an even darker tone. I can also try this by duplicating and making it even darker. So this is my result until now. Perhaps not so dark, that Command Z. Okay. Let's create an even darker tone. Gray 4. Go here, select color range. Let's go to a black area. Now, again, I will reveal everything. I will go to my gray 3, duplicate these, throw them in, and duplicate them again, and rotate them 45 degrees. Now, let's create the complete blacks. Go again, select, sorry, create a new group. Blacks. Select color range. Go to my blacks. And now I will reduce this even more so that I have my absolute blacks here. Again, make the mask. Go to the last gray 4. Duplicate them and throw them in the blacks. Duplicate them and again rotate it. Press Enter to make the transform. Now let's see what we get. So I'm pretty happy here. And I think I will keep it this way. Now, let's create a new layer and call it All. And I will throw everything in here. I also want to get rid of these areas here of the background, so I will create a new mask, go to my airbrush, increase its size and delete them by writing with black on my mask. I think this is okay. Now, I will keep this layer with all, but I will duplicate it and press Command E to flatten it. This way, I will also delete these marks and select Apply. This way, I'll just have my lines here, and I will also lock this. So, now I have a paper downloaded here, a paper texture. which I bring into Photoshop, and I want to give my illustration a nice paper texture. So I will rasterize it, call it paper, and bring it down. Now I want to give an ink color to my lines here, so I will go and give it a nice cyan, a nice like that, and multiply it, and perhaps a little more green, so I will add some green, command backspace, and even more black. Yes, I think this is okay. Nice green ink, or not so green, perhaps a little bluer. Yes, like that. Like, I want to have a pen style. So this is okay now, but let's take it even more to the next level. So I have saved my piece. Go here, Command U to desaturate my paper, and I will save this Command Shift S as map. Let's go to, let's close this one, don't save, reopen my portrait. Now I will go to my layer with the lines, go to filter, distort, displace, and this way my lines will take, leave this as it is, and now Photoshop will ask me to choose a displacement mask. So I will go to my map, and this way my illustration will take the texture of my lines, will take the texture of my paper. And that's it for this tutorial. I hope you find it useful. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you.